जितने 30,000 लोग, 30,000 से ज़्यादा लोग जितने आ रहे हैं यहाँ पर, वो सिर्फ कुछ लोग अपने हेल्थ बेनिफिट्स के लिए लड़ रहे हैं, लेकिन थोड़ा बहुत उनमें सोशल अवेयरनेस जो है उससे भी बढ़ावा मिल रहा है। लड़कियाँ और लड़के दोनों इक्वली सपोर्ट करने आते हैं, बहुत ही एनर्जेटिक हैं, और आई थिंक आजकल की लड़कियाँ बहुत अवेयर हैं और बहुत ही एंटरप्राइजिंग है किसी भी कॉज का सपोर्ट करने के लिए। मैं एक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन को रिप्रेजेंट कर रही हूँ, नवज्योति इंडिया फाउंडेशन, जो डॉक्टर किरण बेदी की का एनजीओ है, और उनके साथ मैं काफ़ी सेक्टर्स में काम करती हूँ, वो एनवायरनमेंट है, एजुकेशन है, तो जिस भी तरह से मैं उनको सपोर्ट कर सकती हूँ, मैं पिछले दो सालों से काम कर रही हूँ उनके साथ, और यहाँ भी एटल डेली हाफ मैराथन में नवज्योति की तरफ से यहाँ भाग रही हूँ और उन्हें सपोर्ट कर रही हूँ। आई थिंक जो यूथ पार्टिसिपेट कर रही है, जो एल्डरली हैं उनको तो मालूम ही है, इसलिए वो यहाँ पर आए हैं कॉज को सपोर्ट करने के लिए, लेकिन जो यूथ भाग रही है, आई थिंक उनको इतना कुछ सीखने को मिल रहा है, इतनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इकट्ठे आ रही हैं जो अलग अलग सोशल कॉजेज़ के बारे में बात कर रही हैं, उनको सपोर्ट कर रही हैं, उनके लिए पैसा इकट्ठा कर रही हैं, तो आई थिंक ये उनका बस अवेयरनेस और बढ़ा रहा है, और आज की डेट में ये शायद भाग रहे होंगे क्योंकि ये मे बी दे फील वेरी हेल्दी।
I'll start by saying that you know, we come from a belief that whatever business that we are doing, we need to build trust with the society, and that can happen only when we leverage and when we use our resources to make a difference. Now, as an organization, we do a number of things. I was just mentioning to Vivek, I lead the United Way of Delhi chapter, and we are big in the nutrition and the food space as Cargill. We work with schools. But all these efforts were happening involving only a few people, you know, the leadership team or some, you know, the organization was giving funds, and which we call, you know, I call that we were enabling things to happen. We felt a need that we needed to get our employees engaged. It was a large, how do you broaden the base of the organization involved in these activities? So how do you make them doers rather than enablers? And this was one activity where you can say it was combining activity with a cause. Now everyone, all those 105 people who are running from my organization, today feel part of a cause and they will have fun. So it is not as if anyone is doing a duty. It's coming out for fun, knowing that while the fun may get over soon, and hopefully they will all run their 6 kilometers and 21 kilometers, the impact of that fun can go a long way. The other point which I think ADHM brings out is that because of the consistency, the organizations that we are supporting can actually plan. Otherwise, you know, all of us do charity, a lot of us do, you know, random charity, and because that's something which is enshrined in most religions in this country, and we are tuned in to do that. All our religions promote us and push us to do that. But what is required is a certain amount of predictability. So when you have an event where corporations know that they will be participating, the organizations that they support actually can plan that this is what I will be getting, and how can I undertake activities which will be funded by this thing. The other thing, and as you would have noticed with the increasing number, and I think where we play a role as a corporation, is that you build this peer pressure. You meet people in your corporate circle, you tell them that you're doing this, this is having a good effect, and this has a cascading effect. So I can at least name five corporates who are led by my friends, and once shared this idea with them, they became part of it. So a number of people that you see running this time would be people who've been in, and I'm sure a lot of other people are doing the same. So this whole connectivity, which typically goes around in the corporate world, can actually be leveraged to expand the participation base by sort of sharing the good example. So for us, I think it's been a great journey, and as you can see, when we started, we were 30 participants. Now it's 105.